Hey guys, Becky here with Design Bundles, and I'm super excited to have you join me today as we go over a very, very important category in your crafting arsenal. We are going to talk about single line designs.
All right, guys, so first and foremost, let's go ahead and talk about where do you find single line designs? And I'm happy to report that single line designs are much easier to find today than they were a few years ago, or even really I would say last year, because there are a lot of products that have come out that have made single line designs very much more in demand and bringing the awareness to designers to say, hey, you know, these single line designs really need to not only be expanded in terms of what designs are available and what fonts are available, but more or less, you know, out there on the marketplace and get their own categories and separate them out. So I've been very happy to see that. Now I'm on Design Bundles. You know, I love the Design Bundles website, of course. And if you go to Crafters and you come down to Single Line Designs, now, of course, if you have a Plus membership, you can come over here, and I do this a lot. I sort least expensive, and then it's going to show me my Plus membership credits first, and I really love that, so go through all those. But sometimes, you know, you're not going to find what you're looking for. I do like to also check out trending, because I feel like this is going to help me find designs that are popular, and of course, I mean, that's always helpful depending on the style that I'm looking for. And naturally, I can sort over here based on, you know, different categories on the left, and I can search in different keywords and categories right here in the search menu. So completely up to you. Now, of course, I picked out two designs from the Plus membership, so let me go ahead and show you those in Silhouette Studio. All right, so let's go ahead and talk about what we have going on here. These are two really, really awesome designs. And I know that I mentioned that there are a lot of tools available for using single line designs. And when I talk about that, I mean sketch pens and markers and sublimation markers and the foil quill and the Cricut transfer system, the foil transfer system, and basically anything, any type of situation where you are wanting to draw something with your Silhouette or with your Cricut instead of cutting out a material. Okay, so sketch pens, you're going to draw, the foil quill, it draws, the Cricut foil transfer kit, it draws. And the more you use those, the more that you'll understand that when you use a regular font or a regular design, it's just going to draw the cut lines. It doesn't actually fill anything in. Now, of course, there are ways to fill it in, and we're not going to get into that today. But just know that, especially for beginners, using these single line designs are really the way to go if those are the type of tools that you're working with. Single line designs are not going to be used for cutting this out in vinyl or cutting. Now, I mean, in some situations, yes, you can cut this out in vinyl. But for example, the I Love You balloon over here. If you were to cut this on your machine, it would cut this just in a single line design. There would be no actual design for you to turn around and use, whether it's vinyl, HTV, cardstock. Okay, so basically this one in particular is only useful if you are in fact going to use it with one of the tools that we just mentioned before. Now, what sets apart single line designs from regular designs? Well, the key is all in the name. These designs are a single line. So let me show you what happens if I try to fill this design in. Okay, that's what we're looking at. All right, and of course, it's going to look wonky, it's going to look weird, and that's because this design is not set up to be cut from a material. And of course, the way that Silhouette Studio and your Cricut and other designing softwares are going to interpret it, it will be interpreted differently, okay? Now, for example, if I wanted to type out, love you, even in a really gorgeous script font, let's zoom in super close, I still have a duplicate set of lines. I have two lines because my machine is actually going to cut this out, whereas a single line design is just going to follow a single path. So hopefully this kind of helps to clarify. Now, are there single line designs that you can also use to cut out with your Cricut or your Silhouette? There are a limited number of them. Okay, for example, I could actually cut this out, and what it would do is my blade would follow the outline, but I would still actually be left with all these inside pieces. Okay, now it would not be ideal because that's not what this is set up for, but I mean, it could technically be done. But guys, the reason that you're seeking out single line designs is because you're wanting to use them with a tool that needs single line designs. Okay, so not only are there single line designs, but there are in fact single line fonts that you can create your own designs with. So that is really super exciting because especially if you're trying to do something like, I don't know, label an envelope, okay? If you wanted to write out an address on an envelope using your sketch pens, having a single line font to be able to type out that address or that name is really, really helpful. And of course, there's a category for that on fontbundles.net as well. So, using the proper website really makes it easy to isolate and be able to use these designs. Now, you may be asking at this point in the video, Becky, are you going to show us what in the world you're talking about? Well, yes and no. Luckily for you guys, I already have videos on two single line design projects. I do an introductory video on using the Cricut transfer foil or foil transfer kit. And then I also do a video on using the foil quill for Silhouette Studio. So two really great designs. And of course they go through how to set up these respective designs in your software, and then you can follow along and complete the entire project. But just know, for the most part, other than a few small details like, you know, the foil quill and the foil transfer, both of those have details with the foil you want to pay attention to. But for the most part, the process is going to be the same. You're going to put paper or cardstock or a similar writable surface, and you are going to be able to insert that sketch pen or insert that sublimation marker or, you know, work with the foils. And there's actually just a lot of really neat effects that you can go through and be able to use these designs for. I really can't stress to you. I mean, like, it's really super great. Like I said, back whenever sketch pens first started getting popular, it was really frustrating trying to find the right font or trying to fill it in, and then it would take forever. That's another really great feature of using single line designs and single line fonts, is there's no waiting for it to fill in. Your machine will literally draw that single line and bam. I mean, you have a completed design in one single movement versus the pen or the foil quill trying to fill in the design, which takes a surprising amount of time. So the final topic to talk about today, because I did already touch on making your own designs with fonts, can you make your own single line designs? Well, yes and no. Silhouette Studio in particular does have the ability to draw lines and to use those fonts. And if you are an artistic person, then this is definitely something that you can start to get into. Now, for those of us with very limited artistic abilities, whenever I draw, I need to draw pen and paper, or I need to draw on my iPad. And to bring in those types of designs and trace them, no, you are not going to get single line designs out of those types of files, because when you trace them, it's going to trace the outside layers of your design, right? Now, you can, in theory, attempt to manipulate those. You can use tools like your internal offset and, you know, try to get your design lines as close as possible. But I'll be honest with you, I've actually tried several times and I've not been overly happy with the results. So I gave up a long time ago, and I consider myself a decent designer. I don't have experience in Adobe Illustrator or Photoshop or Affinity or CorelDRAW or anything like that. I mean, all of my very limited designing experience is in Silhouette Studio, but I consider myself fairly knowledgeable about the software and, you know, different ways and hacks to be able to do designing. And I gave up a long time ago, guys, on trying to create my own single line designs. So I don't want to discourage you. You know, I do believe that exploring these types of designs and, you know, maybe trying, you know, a couple times or try to learn how these are made, I completely support you 110%. I don't ever want any of you guys to be afraid to branch out and try to do something on your own. Just know that the majority of us and the way that our brains operate, we think cut files. And the way that the software is set up, it is set up to create cut files. So I just really urge you, you know, to try to go out in there and find those single line files and single line fonts. And I promise it makes your life 110 times easier. Single line designs also make really awesome coloring book pages. As a matter of fact, this one here, you have already seen in a project. I used it for a sublimation project because you are able to thicken up these lines. So let's talk about that. And that will kind of help us round out the video. These lines, if you know anything about setting up line styles, these lines will not automatically print from Silhouette Studio. Silhouette Studio will draw these lines with your machine, but it will not print these. If you want them to print, then you have to come up here and increase your line thickness. Okay, so, but these really do make really good coloring book files because you can print these out, or you could draw these and hand them over to your kid or yourself. Hey, if you like to color, I'm not judging. And you can hand these out and let them color with something like a sublimation marker, and it really changes the entire design. Now, of course, that's not completely what they're intended for, but I guarantee you guys, the number of things that you can use single line designs for is really, really awesome, but they're easy to be underestimated. So if you take anything away from this video, just know, do not underestimate what all you can use single line designs for, and don't be afraid to think outside the box. Now, naturally, make sure you stay tuned to the channel because we have more single line design tutorials coming for you. And what I mean by that is we are going to explore sketch pens. We are going to explore using the sublimation markers in our machines. And we're also going to explore more items to use with the foil quill and drawing and sketching and engraving and all these awesome things that you can use single line designs for. So I'm going to wrap it up for today, guys, but hopefully this was a good introductory video for you to better understand what these files are, what they can be used for, and how they differ from regular designs.
So guys, how did you feel about learning more about single line designs? Now, I really like them. I love using them with my foil quill. I love using them also with my sketch pens. There's just really a lot of cool things that you can do better with single line designs than you can with your regular designs. So hopefully you'll take the time to learn more about them and experiment with them. And as promised, I do have more videos coming up that will show you more project inspiration. So guys, if you have any questions or comments, please make sure you leave that below. I do love to hear from you guys. And of course, if you learned something today, make sure you give us a like, subscribe to the channel, and maybe share with a crafty friend. All of those things really help to support us and to help us keep bringing you these videos in the future. So guys, I'm going to wrap it up for today, but I do really appreciate you taking time to stop by, and we will see you again next time.